Hey, it's Anna. Welcome back to Mirror Mirror. And if you're new here, hi, I'm an independent music artist. I write, record, and produce my own music. And I also film 4 videos a week here on my YouTube. And this series is all about relationships because they are the key to life. So this video was requested on my Instagram because in a previous video, which I will link up here somewhere, I talked about the fact that we try and get people to become their potential, and this person asked me to talk about how to stop doing that, which I feel like is kind of funny that she asked me that because I'm so guilty of this even now. So I don't really know, but I do know the ways that are helping me to stop. So I figured I would film a video on it and share how to kind of work towards not doing it. And also my kind of basic understanding, I'm just trying to open up my notes, by the way, my basic understanding of why we do it and how to stop doing it, like the practical step-by-step ways of stopping, although I haven't actually achieved each step just yet, but we're getting there. So what did I write? Okay, they won't be their potential. I think the realization, first of all, that people won't be their potential is such an important thing to see and realize, but oftentimes we don't want to see that because it kind of shatters the illusion that we hold for them. So if you see somebody as being this, like, I don't know, you could see them as being like an incredible person, somebody that communicates perfectly and is very open and vulnerable and honest with you and all of these things. Like, you could see them as being capable of reaching that, but if they're not working towards that, then they're not going to be that, at least not right now. So you have to decide whether you're okay with accepting the fact that right now they're not working towards that, and you don't know if they will in the future. And this is the difficult part, is that, like, just because you can see that somebody is capable of something and could do something doesn't mean they actually will do it. So I feel like the first step is in self-awareness and realizing that you are perceiving a version of them that they're not currently being. Like, you need to be aware of that fact, because if you're not aware of it, then you're never gonna change it, you know? So once you become aware of the fact that you're seeing somebody's potential and they're not actually it, then you can take the steps towards no longer doing this, I guess, which of course is a process. It's not gonna happen instantly, so go easy on yourself, you know? Like, we're rewiring our brains here. These are habits and things that we do constantly with different relationships all the time. So when you're trying to change something like this, you're literally reprogramming your mind, rewiring your brain to do things differently, to think differently, to behave differently. So that's a process, and it's not something that's going to just switch for you. So it's okay, it will be fine, but you just become aware of it first. And in becoming aware of it, like, that's the first key step to anything in life. So the fact that you're watching this video, maybe you're aware of the fact that you do it, and that's really cool. And then the next step is to look at why. Why we do this. So maybe it's because you know that if that person does not meet their potential, then it means that you're not actually compatible, because it's not something that you're willing to settle for. And the idea of not being compatible with somebody is absolutely terrifying, especially when you love them or you care about them, you want to be with them. So I feel like there's a number of reasons why we go for someone's potential and we try and, like, put that potential on them even though they're not actually it. So it could be out of an insecurity, it could be just out of fear, to be honest. It's normally just fear in a million different angles and ways that it shows itself. So becoming aware of the root of why you keep perceiving their potential and then not acknowledging the fact that they're not actually that, I think it's really important to know why, because once you know why, then you can hold a bit more compassion for yourself and the fact that you're scared to admit that they're not their potential, or you're scared to admit that you're not compatible, or scared to admit anything, you know? Because essentially, when we want somebody to reach their potential, it's because who they are actually who they are right now is not a match for us. Otherwise, we wouldn't want them to get to that potential, because we'd be happy with who they are right now. We'd be satisfied with that. And if you're not and you keep reaching for their potential, then it's because there's a misalignment here. Like, they're not in alignment with you. The potential version of them might be in alignment with you, but the current version of who they really are isn't. So becoming aware of why you're doing it, and maybe it's because it's not compatible, whatever that reason may be, is an important step. So then, and a scary step, but an important step. So then you can work towards changing it and doing things differently, I guess is the right phrase. So once you're aware it's happening and you're aware of why it's happening, then you can take the steps now to stop doing that. And I feel like this is probably the hardest part, of course, but some ways to do that are, when it's happening, you'll notice that it's happening because you're aware that you're doing it, and then you're like, okay, why am I doing it? Okay, now I'm aware of why I'm doing it. So now what can I do about it? What can I do about the fact that they're not their potential? This other version is who they really are. So now you have to acknowledge the fact that this is who they are. Like, looking at who they actually are is literally the next step and the kind of key, really, in that relationship dynamic. But if you're doing it to everybody, then obviously becoming aware of why you're doing it is definitely essential. And then you can work through those emotions and reasons of why you're doing it to try and change that and stop yourself from doing that. And I feel like stopping yourself from doing that is kind of a weird sort of phrase, because really you can't stop yourself. What you can do is stop those thoughts when they come up. Like, you can't prevent them from coming up, but when they come up, you can be like, hang on a second, that's based in potential. That's not based in reality right now. That's not based in the present. That's based in the future of who I wish they would be. So let me bring myself back to the present. Who are they right now? Who actually are they in this moment? Is that thought of what I want them to be, is that something that they actually are doing? Have I seen them do that? Have they said those words? Have they behaved in that way? Like, is that something that they really are doing right now? Or is that something I wish they were doing, or I'm scared they will do, or something that is based in the future but hasn't physically happened yet? Like, you have to analyse these thoughts, because essentially the idea of potential is a thought in your mind. It's not a version of them that you're witnessing in the present, because it's a future version. So what you're becoming aware of is your thought patterns. You're becoming aware of what you're thinking. And when you become aware of what you're thinking, then you can kind of analyze, like self-analyze those thoughts by stepping out of the thinker and becoming the observer, which I know sounds kind of weird, but if you meditate, this will be a normal kind of practice for you, is like, instead of continuing to think those thoughts, you stop yourself and be like, okay, and you start asking yourself questions like, okay, I just thought about their potential and about how I wish that they were, or how I want them to be, or how they could be so much more understanding. And I just had this thought about them being understanding. Okay, so are they actually understanding? No. Do I wish they were understanding? Yes. Can I see them be understanding? Like, can I visualize that in my mind? Yes. But are they that now? No. Okay then, so it's in the future. It's something I wish would happen. And when you're aware of the fact that it's in the future and it's not in the present, now you can choose to no longer judge them or interact with them based on the future. You can choose to then, okay, that's a future thing. Now let me go to the present. Who are they in the present? What kind of things do they do in the present? Like, how understanding are they in the present? Let me think of some examples of memories and things that have happened in the past that are about how understanding they are. Like, I'm just using understanding as an example so you can kind of understand what I mean. But yeah, so then you can look at the present and all of the things that they're doing right now and the things that they've done in the past as well that show who they are when it comes to understanding or being understanding towards you, or whatever area of your connection and relationship it is that you're trying to figure out. And then I really feel like once you're aware of who they are now, it's just a case of acceptance. It's like, okay, I really wish they could be this thing in the future. Like, I can see their potential. They could be such a cool person, such a kind person. But in the present, they're not that. So now it's like, okay, I have to accept who they are in the present. Because who they are in the present is who they're choosing to be. And yeah, they could choose the future version, but who they are right now is a choice. You know, we all have a choice, just like who you are right now is a choice. So who they are right now is their choice. They have free will and we cannot control people. So you then have to just accept that fact. Accept it about them, but you can also accept it about all parts of yourself as well. This is who they are. And then in that acceptance, you decide whether they are compatible with you or not, whether they're somebody that you want to keep in your life or not, and in what way you want them to be in your life. Does that mean that they become a friend instead of a romantic partner? Does that mean that you see them every now and then just as an acquaintance, but it's not like a close person? Or do you cut them off fully? Like, you have to decide for yourself what kind of dynamic works best for you based upon who they are and who you are right now in this present moment. So yeah, that's kind of how you stop seeing people from their potential, is just becoming aware of the fact that you're doing it and then bringing yourself back to the present and acknowledging who they are and who you are in the present. And it's a daily process and it takes time. And there may be times where you wander off into the future potential, like we're all guilty of it and it's completely fine. But eventually you'll become aware of it again and then you'll have to remind yourself of the present and just constantly ground yourself back into your body, bring yourself back into the present, because we're not in the future. We're not trying to live from the future. We're here right now, and this is who each person is right now, and we can't wait for their potential to happen. We have to acknowledge who they are right now, because anything can happen tomorrow, you know? This is who they are right now. So yeah, I hope this video was helpful. Definitely comment down below if you have anything to add or any questions or anything that you want me to elaborate on further. Definitely let me know. And you can check out the description box because my phone number is there as well as my social media links. So if you want to DM me with any other video topic ideas, feel free to do so because I'm always, always open to ideas. And yeah, check out the description box. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already, because I do upload 4 times a week, and I will see you in the next video. Bye. You could say I love you. I can't get enough, but I just want you to myself.